from George in Orlando, and it has something to do with criminal defense, and I know that's what you do on a day-to-day basis. George, you're on News Talk WDBO. Go ahead.
Well, I appreciate you hosting the radio show, and Mr. Dennis, I can't pronounce your last name.
That's fine. But thank call you me Dennis.
Taking my call.
Go ahead.
This is my question. My son the other day was arrested at a local park. They had less than 1 gram of marijuana, him and a friend. I think it's like half a joint they had. And they were also cited for having like a little grinder. The officer, when he called, said it was like paraphernalia.
Right, right.
It was a $500 ticket, and for that, and a $100 fine for the marijuana. But my question is, he has no prior offenses. He's 19. He's in college. And I don't want anything on his record. Can you help us with that?
I sure can. These crimes, first of all, a lot of lawyers talk to the legislature about decriminalizing these crimes because they take up a lot of time in court, and of course we spend a lot of money doing it, in the sense that the court system has to put their lights on, has to have a judge, have to have two prosecutors, bailiffs, and court deputies, and everything else in the courtroom. This is a very easy case to handle. All you need to get is a withhold. There are some diversion programs. If you get either a withhold of adjudication of guilt, which means no formal conviction, which everybody gets on these kind of cases, and in both things, then you can – or you can get onto a diversion program that will lead your way to an expunction of the record so your kid can honestly say, with a few exceptions, that he's never been arrested for anything.
Hey, George, I'm curious, because your son was with a friend, did they charge him both with that crime, or did they pick one of them and it happened to be your son?
That's a great question, and I'm not sure when it happened. My son called. The officer allowed him to call from the scene, and he told me what happened. But they split the friend up and my son up, and I'm not sure if the other child, he's 19 as well, I'm not sure if he was also charged. The officer, since he made contact with us, the parents, he didn't, you know, impound the car or anything like that.
Okay, and then I think
if it was in a car, excuse me, Tom, if it were in a car and they were both in there, the state must prove that they had dominion and control, the ability to maintain dominion and control, and that they had knowledge. If one of them did not have knowledge of it or said that it was his, then we can get that guy off. That's not a problem.
And then I'm just curious, George, and you can answer this too, Dennis, do they write his son a ticket for this, or do they put him in handcuffs him to jail?
They probably gave him a notice to appear so he wouldn't have to go to jail. It's not like a ticket, because a ticket is a citation, for example, for speeding is a civil matter, a civil infraction, but possession of pot and possession of paraphernalia are criminal. So, George, let me make a suggestion to you. If you call my office, I'll give you a free conference. I'll talk to you and your son and explain everything to you a little bit deeper. But yeah, this is a very easy case to handle. It's one that can result in him not having a record, so it's worth pursuing.
Very good. Thank you for calling. We do appreciate it, George, and best of luck to your son, and hopefully this will not cause too much problems and issue as far as his future goes, because it certainly is not reasonable under most circumstances to be charged with that amount of pot. Hey, Dennis, we've been talking about how you get back to the community, and another way one I want to focus on is your legal